In this video, we are going to talk about Claude Code version 2, which uses Claude Sonnet 4.5. I'm going to show you how you can run this Claude Code on your computer, on your VS Code, and how you can use it, what are the changes and benefits that you can get with this update. So if you're ready, let's begin. All right, so as you know, recently Claude published a new update. They published different products, different new products, and one of them was Claude Code version 2. And it's really helpful if you have a project, if you are coding, but you don't want to spend a lot of time writing the code or finding the errors. It will do everything for you. All you need to do is to write prompts and tell that AI model what to do. So first, let's talk about how you can install Claude Code on your computer. So all you need to do, if you are on Mac, press Command and a space, then a search bar comes, write down Terminal to open Terminal. If you are on Windows, open CMD, right, the command line. And there, you can, you must have Node and NPM to be able to install it. So to check if you have it, I will also copy and paste all of these commands inside the description of this video. So I'm just going to write down node-v to check if I have it. If you see, for example, version something, it means that you have it. Now let's check npm, npm-v. I also have this. And then you can just copy and paste this line, okay, to install Claude Code on your computer. So it will take a couple of seconds. As you can see, it added 3 packages and it was successful. Sometimes you may face error. Okay, you may see errors here. And for that, you can, if you already have Claude, you can write down Claude update. Okay. If not, you can write Claude install. Okay. Now sometimes when you write this, it just gives you more error because of permission and some other problems. So what you can do is to write this line, Claude space migrate dash installer. Now, when you write this, it will install Claude directly. It will not use NPM. It will just install Claude directly on your computer. And to check if it was successful, all you need to do is write Claude space dash dash version. So I'm going to come here and write this. And as you can see, now I have access to Claude Code version 2. And sometimes when you install it, you need to restart your terminal. So you can write this code here. Just copy and paste this code to restart your terminal and then check your version again, the Claude version again. Now, when you do this, all you need to do is to just move to your project by writing CD and then write the for example, write the destination. Let me just close this from here. Write the destination. And here I have a file. I'm just going to drag and drop it here to get the address and press enter. Now I'm in this file. And all I need to do is to write Claude. This way, by writing the word Claude, you are calling Claude. And now here you can just write your prompts. For example, explain what folders do we have in this project. So it will look at your project, it will look at your folders, and it will explain. We have these files, that files, right? So this project has no folders, it's only contained 2 Python files, and so on, okay? So this is how it works. You can write your prompt, you can ask Claude to make some changes, but to make it even easier, you can also add Claude into VS Code. To do that, all you need to do is to come to this page. I will put the link down in the description. And install Claude Code for VS Code. Click on it, install it, and then you will see something like this on your VS Code. So the way it works is that here at the top, you see a Claude icon. If you just click on it, Claude appear here, and you can write your prompt here, and there are some options here. So let's talk about these options. So the way it works is that it has 3 mode, to work. The first mode is that ask before edit. So I will give it a task. Then it will do all its processing. Then when it comes to a point that it wants to do something or make some changes, first it will show me that, hey, I want to make these changes. I want to remove these codes and add these codes. Are you happy with it or not? If you are happy, you can write, you can just select yes, or you can say no, I don't like it, make it this way. Okay, so this is the first mode. The second mode is edit automatically, which sometimes for simpler projects, I will put it like this. And this way you just give it a task and it will just complete the process. It will make the changes, save the files, complete it for you, test it for you, and then you're ready to try it. And the next version is that plan mode, which first it will create a plan about the task that you gave. It will tell you that first we're going to do this, second we're going to do this. You will review the plan. If you're happy with it, you can execute. If you're not happy with it, first you can work with Cloud on designing a better plan, then executing, right? And here on each file that you are, you can see the file here. And if you just click on it, it will hide this file from Claude Code. So Claude Code will not read this file. It is good for cases that you have some file that in a specific task, you don't want Claude to touch it, or maybe it's distracting or something, you just want to hide it. And here we have a slash. If you click on it, you can see the commands for Claude. And it's not important to know them. It's not, if you can just go through with it, there are some explanation in front of each one of them. But I don't use it a lot, right? The prompting here will do all the work. So this is generally how you can use Claude Code on Visual Studio. Now here, let me show you, I ran a task earlier. So here I have a plugin that the progress bar, it was very basic, okay? It was not showing exactly all the steps. And this plugin, what it does, it generate images inside Photoshop using different AI models. Right now we have Cedrin 4, we have Nano Banana, and we have Quinn, right? It will use these models based on the prompt that we have here to generate images. Now, I wanted to improve this progress bar, and let me show you in this video how it was before. So this is how it looked before. You see, it's a simple processing. It just write on a status and there's a progress bar, but I wanted something more complex, more detailed to show everything and what is happening at that moment, especially if you are using different models at the same time. I wanted my user to see right now CDream is generating an image, right now Nano Banana is generating an image, and so on. Okay, so what I did, I came on Claude Code on Visual Studio, and I mentioned when we generate an image, we see the progress bar. I want to update this, improve it, make it better, show all the status and so on. So one of the great things in this update is that now Claude Code create a list of tasks. So you give a massive task to it, it will divide it into smaller tasks, which is really good because now it can focus on each task separately. It will decrease the chance of mistakes, right? So it created this list. First, I'm going to examine the progress bar, the current progress bar. Then I'm going to analyze how multiple AI models are handled. Then I'm going to check. Then I'm going to design improved process display. I'm going to design it. Then I'm going to implement it, right? And then I'm going to test it. This is the list it created by itself. Then it went through the files. Now let's read index.html, let's read index.js. And as you can see, if it is green, it was successful. If it is red, it failed. And usually for big files, maybe it failed at the first try, then it will use other ways to read that file. So it continued, it went through all of the files, analyzed them, right? And as you can see, it crossed these two steps. And now it's designing the improved progress display. So here, every time that it wants to change a code, it will show it like this, that you can just come here and click on it. The red part is the part that it removed it. The green parts are the codes that it added, right? And you can see, for example, here in style.css, these are the changes. And in some other part of this code, it made some other changes as well. And it went to the next step. It's tried to implement it on the JavaScript code that we have. And finally, it tested. The thing is that on the previous versions of Claude, Claude had the chance, 9% chance of making mistakes. Now, in this new version, it is almost zero. It is close to zero. Why? Because first of all, they divide the task into smaller parts. And most important, they test it, right? So Claude tests what it wrote for you, for your project. And if it was successful, it will save it. If it's not successful, it will make some changes, right? So this way, you get a code that actually works. That's why the chance of making mistake, it's not much. It's close to zero. And finally, it will give you a comprehensive report of what it did, which is really, it looks really good and it is easy to understand. On the previous version, it was really hard and they made a great upgrade here. So for example, in this file, index.html, at this line, we have updated this structure. In this file, we added comprehensive CSS for the new progress system. In this file, we did that, and it's really good. You understand the whole process and how it goes. And another thing, which it's a small, but I really like it, is that, for example, when I write something here, before on the Claude Code version 1, if I wanted to go to the next line, if I press Enter, or if I press Shift, if I hold Shift and press Enter, it was just submitting the prompt, which was really bad. So if I wanted to go to the next line, I couldn't. But now they fix that. Now I can hold Shift and go to the next line, which I'm really happy about this. This was another, it was a minor update, but it really works, especially when you are giving a massive prompt to Claude Code. Here is the debug log. Here is the errors. Here are this file. I'm going to put it here. Is the content of this file. I'm going to paste it here. So when it is, the prompt is very complicated, it becomes really hard to understand it. But when you go to the next line, you can manage it easier. And also we understand it much better, right? So these are the main differences, the main changes in Claude Code. And of course, it is much, much smarter. And I will keep testing this. I will keep using it. And soon I'm going to create another video on the use cases for Claude Code and tips and tricks. So don't forget to like this video if you are interested in this topic. And don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss the next upcoming videos, especially that I'm going to create video trainings on Imagine with Claude and Claude extension for Chrome, which are really amazing. The videos will come out soon, so don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss them. That was all for this video. I hope you liked it. If you have any question or if you have an idea or you have a comment, you can write it below. I read all of your comments and respond to them. And I look forward to see you soon on the next video.